Keyword clustering is where you group keywords together with similar meaning or intent, normally with the help of AI, for better rankings in the search results. So here's something here, low cost, high profit business ideas. You can see all the keywords there that have been grouped together that all have the same sort of meaning. You can see there, low cost, high profit business ideas, low cost business ideas with high profit. They kind of all mean the same thing. Obviously you can do it manually, but it's more time consuming and complex. So let me illustrate with an example. So here's a page here. You can see the clicks are in blue. It was getting, you know, a lot of clicks, and it's just tanked over a period of time. So if I was to look at, let's say, the last month, if we look at some of the kind of keywords here that the page is ranking for, so we've got online business ideas at position 10. It's getting some clicks, you can see the impressions, but if you look at some of these ones, let me just sort them by impressions. So if we look at these ones, home-based business ideas, 124 impressions, position 47, home-based businesses UK, positions 30-35. So you can see there that there's some impressions, some decent impressions, but the positions are very high, which is sort of telling me that the page content isn't very relevant. So ideally, I should probably create a new page called home-based business ideas. But the thing is, if you're doing kind of keyword research, you've got access to Google Search Console. You can export that data, but you only get 1,000 queries. So you can take this data, you can take business ideas data from Ahrefs. You can see there's 18,000 keywords. I use a tool called Phrase, which basically integrates with Google Search Console, and I think it gives you about, I think it's a 16 months worth of data, but if we look at the download data here, 14,000 keywords or queries which you can then download. So the idea is basically take data from Google Search Console, take it from Ahrefs, take it from Phrase, and then what you do is basically, you can see here I've got this master sheet which I've already, I'm not going to bore you with how you do that here, but basically you can see there I've taken the Search Console data, I've taken the data from Phrase, I've taken the data from Ahrefs, I've put it into a master sheet, and then basically then what I do is I then export that there with a CSV, and I use a tool there called Keywords Insight, and you can see there's one that I've done it earlier. You basically give the name, you name the project, your location, the language. You've got these different options here, which you basically, for me, I just go cluster and rank. If it's an existing website, just cluster option. If it's a new project you're working on, leave these settings as is. Basically, go through to the next. So when you select rank, that'll ask you to kind of add your URL. So it'll give you a credit there, etc. If you've got an account, you just use your credits up. If you've not got an account, you can basically just pay as you go. Then you'll get this report here, it comes through here, you then open that up. And what you'll get is you'll get this report here. So let me explain what this report means. So in the first column here, you've got the cluster. And the cluster is basically the page. And then you've got the keywords, so that you can see here, this one here, low cost, high profit business ideas. The tool has clustered all these keywords together that have similar meaning and similar intent. And so basically, and then what it does is then gives you kind of search volume. I've added this other column in here to say, yes, I should add this to my website plan. So all in all, from all the keywords, it's come back there, there's about 140 pages, although to be honest, some of these business ideas, Australia is not relevant to me. So again, there's probably realistically about 70 to 80 pages that I could create, which are all about business ideas. Is if you go to the Hub tab, you can create this structure called Hub and Spoke, or you've probably heard of things like, you know, pillar pages and cluster pages. So what it does is the tool does here is that it kind of groups them together into this kind of like structure. So it's basically saying here that I could create like a pillar page or a hub around about small business ideas, and within that hub of small business ideas I could create all these pages. And then within online business ideas, so I would create a pillar page about online business ideas, or let's say it's not necessarily a hub, you could also just simply create a category within WordPress called online business ideas, and then within that category you would create all these pages. Again, you would have to go through there and select which ones are relevant. And again, there's all these other sort of hubs that could create business ideas for women. You know, there's one there, a page there about business ideas for women, nursing business ideas for housewives, Mother's Day business ideas, and so on. So, you know, there's one there, create a hub there about sustainable business ideas. So we've got future ideas, recycling ideas, renewable energy ideas. I know the search volume is low and stuff like that, etc. But I mean, that's not the thing. Is that I might not have kind of like identified all the keywords in these tools. I might have kind of like, you know, missed some of them out. So again, you don't have to follow this structure by, you know, it's not gospel, but it's a kind of good way to do it. So the next question would be, well, wait a minute, I'm already ranking. I already have pages about these kind of topics. You know, what do I do? So what you do is you get to the pivot table by URL column. And basically what you do is you just collapse it all like so. So you'll see all the pages. I mean, this is obviously a basic version here. You're going to get something that's more like this here, where you've got all the different pages. So if I was to just open up this one here, there's this URL here. We've got my top ranking keywords here. Keyword Research Services, Keyword Research Service, Keyword Research Agency. I'm at position 1, 1, 2, and 3. So these would all kind of remain under the page that's the cluster called Keyword Research Services. But this one here, you've got Keyword Research Report. So that's basically telling me I should create a page about Keyword Research Report, because you can see I'm at position 65. This page is ranking for Keyword Research Report at position 65, but it's not really relevant, which is why I should create a new page. And then we've got the other keyword here, SEO, Keyword Research Report, because it kind of means the same thing as Keyword Research Report. So that's telling me, but again, this is basically just to help you work out, you know, what pages are matching up with what keywords. But as I said, you know, that's all going to be identified in this report here. So if I go back to my original one here, we've got, open this up. So we've got the page there about business ideas. The main keyword is online business ideas, which would remain in this page here because it's got the highest search volume, position 10. But this one here, business ideas UK, means something different. So, you know, it would be under a different page. This one here, home business ideas and business ideas, that you can see that they would all fall under small business ideas from home. So you would know by looking at this tab here about which keywords are assigned to your existing pages and which keywords would go to kind of new pages. Now, obviously, if you've got an existing site that ranks for thousands of keywords, you have lots of pages, doing all this analysis is going to take a lot longer than just simply creating new pages or clusters or new hubs and pillar pages. So I hope that was kind of useful and I explained it.